With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. Verstappen, Leclerc, and Lewis Hamilton. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. It's race day here in Melbourne as we continue with what could shape up to be one of the best Australian Grand Prix ever. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 14 corners and 3.28 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles per hour. The close proximity of the barriers make accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Perez, Carlos Sainz, and Fernando Alonso, Russell, Ocon, Norris, and Daniel Ricciardo, Gasly, Bottas, Kevin Magnussen, and Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, Joe, Alex Albon, and Lance Stroll, Vettel, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. And what would any Grand Prix weekend be without the one and only Natalie Pinkham? Why don't we kick off by discussing Max Verstappen?
Well, it was a really impressive lap in qualifying to get pole position, but are they going to be able to hold on to the lead into the first corner with so many quick starters around them? A couple of favourites for the win today then, but who comes out on top doesn't really matter as long as they give us an entertaining show en route to the chequered flag. And we want to see fair fighting, of course, out there on track, so let's hope the stewards don't have to get involved too much today.
The formation lap gets underway then, and it's going to be interesting today to see how the dry conditions could affect the lifespan of the tyres. Positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
DRS is now available. Verstappen's ahead of you. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 4.0 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. Their tyres are 3 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. And the time last lap was a 1 minute 22.4. Behind is 2.6 seconds. rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes. Rain is going to be with us for a while now. Okay, dry seem like the best tyre for now. On those slicks. These conditions are making the line a bit greasy, but we're still nowhere near the changeover point. Okay, here's some information on Latifi. Okay, they're out of this race. Perfect situation, but I don't think we've got cause to move on to a different tyre yet. Light rain will stay with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay. Dry's definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Now disabled DRS. DRS is now disabled. Minutes of light rain. Okay, dry seem like the best tyre for now. Track conditions aren't improving. It's your choice as to whether you want to fit full wets next time you come in. Okay, clear. Strategy available on the MFD. Okay, copy that. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of it. Carlos is in the pits. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy, come on. Nice move, good job. Russell's behind you now. OK, the gap behind is 0.9 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Time last lap was a 1:28.4. Rain conditions for the foreseeable future. Inters seem to be the fastest tyre for now. Teammate by 4.8 seconds. position, run to the pack. Russell behind, and the gap behind us is 1.8 seconds. They're on old intermediates. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. 2.0 seconds. Rain's going to keep getting heavier for the next 15 minutes at least. Russell's behind you now. Okay, so the gap to the car behind is 1.1 seconds. They're on old intermediates. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 29.7. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. enough fuel for three more laps. Final lap of the race. Gap to your teammate behind is 8.7 seconds.
Performance from Ferrari, it hardly looked in doubt. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
It's an heroic effort for any driver to race in conditions like these, and seeing them fight their way to the front was very special indeed. They were able to find all the grip, all the good lines, and had the confidence to get on the power to top it all off. That's what pushed them into first place today.
Ferrari are at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Charles Leclerc, currently leading the championship standings, extends his lead even further with this result. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
There are a few contenders, but George Russell definitely stood out, I think. A really solid drive from him today, and one I'm sure the fans enjoyed.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. Well, that was certainly an exciting weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for more exciting Formula One action very soon.